They both were hushed, the voice, the chords. I heard but once that witching lay, and few the notes and few the words, my spellbound memory brought away. Traces remembered here and there, like echoes of some broken strain, links of a sweetness lost in air, that nothing now could join again. Even these too, ere the morning, fled, and though the charm still lingered on, that over each sense her song had shed, the song itself was faded, gone. Gone like the thoughts that once were ours, on summer nights ere youth had set, thoughts bright, we know, as summer flowers, though what they were, we now forget. In vain with hints from other strains, I wooed this tyrant air to come, as birds are taught on eastern plains to lure their wilder kindred home. In vain the song that Sappho gave, in dying to the mournful sea, not muter slept beneath the wave than this within my memory. At length one morning, as I lay in that half-waking mood when dreams unwillingly at last gave way to the full truth of daylight's beams, a face, the very face, methought, from which had breathed as from a shrine of song and soul the notes I sought, came with its music close to mine, and sang the long-lost measure over, each note and word with every tone, and look that lent it life before, all perfect, all again my own.